Hi, and welcome to Eleanor Does Audio Stuff. So, I have Ableton Move here, and after a couple of weeks of using it, I can totally see it in my workflow, especially when I need to get my creative ideas down really quickly, whether I'm in a studio or on the road. That's why I thought it would be really fun to show how I make a track with Move in standalone mode in 10 minutes, which you can also follow and start using your Move ASAP. Okay, let's get going. 10 minutes on a clock now. Awesome. So, well, firstly, we need to find an empty set, which we can find from these three dots. We go here and there's a folder sign. And now you can see all the sets that are available. That's recording, yes. And example, we have demo sets here. Woo! But we don't want a demo set now, we want an empty one. So all these gray ones are empty slots. So we can click one of them, it says empty set. We click here and we activate the set 23, which is our new empty set. But it's not fully empty because what Move does, it actually gives us four instruments automatically on the four tracks that we have available. So example, drum kit, really cool sound. Ooh, acid bass. Ooh, very gentle keys. And a lead. What a combination. So now, first, before we start making the track, we need to go and set tempo. So settings, again, clock sign there, and tempo is 127. There we go. And then we have metronome on. Woohoo! And then we also have key. So now you can see that it's in chromatic scale. So if we don't want to have that, which makes it a little bit more difficult, especially if you don't know music theory, go in key, which means that whatever you play now on the instrument, it's gonna be on the key that you set, which we can set from here. So example F, we can go to D minor, which I prefer here. Now it's in D minor, and whatever I play here, it's gonna be on D minor, which is awesome. Cool, so let's start with drums. So if we wanna replace this kit, we're gonna click the track, and then we're gonna go here, and let's go and see the category. So back, and we have acoustic kits, electric kits, hybrid kits. I want an electronic one, and I've already found some cool sounds that I prefer, just so that the 10 minutes is not me just finding sounds. So I think it was control kit is the one that I like. Perfect for some house music, which I like, melodic house. Okay, we're gonna start with kick, which is very usual for four on the floor kick pattern, which is usual for house music. So I press play and we get this pattern going on the sequencer. We put four on the floor, so one beat on each beat, one kick on each beat. Snare. Cool! We got rhythm going on straight away. I can press this and I can make the snare a little bit quieter and also adjust where the sample starts playing. Example there. Attack maybe a little bit slower. And now let's add some hi-hats. So I can play on the top. And now I can use Capture MIDI, which is here. And whatever I played, you saw I didn't record anything, but I played and it captures whatever I just jammed on the top. Cool. And let's just quantize that. Cool. And now there's actually a really cool effect I want to show you. So on the hi-hats, there's this, always on the drum kit, you find this playback effect area here. So you can see that there's different type of playback effects we can choose from. And from there, there's one called stretch. So let's add stretch factor to the hi-hat. It adds this cool like tail thing, which adds a really cool groove to it. And now let's finger drum some tom on the top. Qu- quantize, we can transpose it, sample start, and playback effect, let's go this punch. That's cool, a little bit less volume there. And let's take the click off now because we don't need metronome anymore because we have a beat. That's kind of groovy. Lovely. Okay, let's go and add, we have about 5 minutes. Let's go and add a lead. I don't really like that one, so let's go and select another instrument. And I kind of like, there was a one in the pluck instruments that I like called Kondo. There. I like atmospheric stuff. So let's go and just jam something on the top of there. Oh, there was a mistake sound, and that is fine because now we can use this, which is delete clip, or we can go return, which cancels whatever you just created. So we can just delete this clip and start again. And there was a little bit mistake there, but that's fine. I could actually make this loop 2 bars long. And it's just repeating that, which is really cool. Let's add some low pass filter. And you know what we can now add is some effects. So example, if you go to the track and then scroll a little bit left and right, you can see there's a phase flanger and then there's a delay. So let's go phase flanger, and we can now from the mode, we can go flanger instead of phaser. And then the last one is always dry wet. Flanger time, feedback. Adds an interesting effect there. That's kind of cool. Another one we can add, it was the delay. And we can always go back to the instrument and add some high pass filter, the filtering we want to. That's really cool. So let's go to the bass. I don't think this acid one is right for this. So there was a one that was cool. It was like a... organ bass, there. And we can go octave lower. And let's just create a very basic housey beat. Let's go return and do again. Cool, and quantize again. And now what we can do, there is FM amount and wave position, and what we could do is automate them. So what we could do with automation is we just press record and start using the parameters. Same wave position. That's really cool. I like that. So we already done effects, automation. So now we can do some sampling. And this is one of my favorite things. So here we have a sampler. So I go to the empty instrument, which we have not added yet, and I activate the sampler. And there is actually a microphone here. So you can see a signal is coming in. And that microphone we can now use really fast. And that's why I like this, is that I don't need to bring, like, you know, microphone with me or anything. I can just use this or the internal speaker to kind of wherever I am create things fast. And I like crackly stuff, so I have actually this candy wrapper here. So I'm gonna record this with a note that I'm gonna sing. Do 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 go with that. And let's see how it sounds. And if we want to, again, change the location of the sample, that's really cool. Let's put release longer. I like that. We can transpose it. Oh, it says done, but I'm not done. I'm just gonna really quickly finish this sound, because that sounds really cool. And I wanna add just a little bit reverb. Let's add some large. And maybe some, oh, no, I went there again. Delay. And where's the feedback time? Let's go like. That is so cool. Let's just record that. There, but I don't actually mind it. We can quantize it again. Okay, so now how do I get this, what I just created here in Move, about 10 minutes and 30 seconds, into my Ableton Live to kind of finish it up and create a full track out of it? So I'm going to show you how to do that using a browser. You need to connect your Move into Wi-Fi and then go to your browser on computer and go to move.local on the browser. And this allows you now to connect your Move to Move Manager. For Move Manager, we can go to Sets and download the set that we have just created. And this is what I created after the 10 minutes. It's just a little fun sketch of a track. Make me feel safe. Channel, you'll find a lots and lots and lots of Ableton Live and Push content. So keep on learning from these videos here. Remember to subscribe and see you here again soon. Happy creative time. Bye.